next on NTC News. NIU opens its doors and rolls out a welcome mat to high schoolers. And we'll tell you about a local action group that's speaking out against the president. Plus, a Northern Star reporter joins us with more on his ongoing series about undocumented immigrants. NTC News starts now.
You're watching NTC News, DeKalb County's only television news source. On the campus of Northern Illinois University and from the Northern Television Center, this is NTC News Tonight.
High schools visited NIU today to see all that the campus has to offer. Hello, I'm Yashay Boss. Thanks for joining us.
And I'm Eric Martin. It's February 23rd.
The 33rd annual Talentative program brought the students to the university.
Sam Schweiss went to the morning's meet and greet, and she's joining us now with more on the story. Hey, Sam.
Hey, thanks, guys. So every year, in honor of Black History Month, high schoolers are invited to NIU to spend a day and a night on campus.
While starting out their day at the Sky Room for a motivational speech for students not to give up.
You should party. Or what did you come to school here for? To graduate.
Students have the chance to visit different centers and take a tour around campus. The program is designed with mentors to keep the students on the right path for their future.
So the Talented 10th was created by W.E.B. Du Bois, and he was saying that the Talented 10th is the top 10% of individuals who go to college and who are supposed to reach back and go to their community and help them out. So as a mentor now, I feel like that's my place to go back and help individuals from my hometown, Chicago, or from anywhere. You can be from a different state, but I do think that it's very important to be able to reach out to the youth and give them something to look up to.
Students end the two-day activity Friday with more presentations pursuing students to get some sort of post-secondary education.
The next teen activity is held in April, titled Teen Summit. The event is for students and community leaders to discuss current events.
Business owners in downtown DeKalb want more NIU students to see what they have to offer. The Daily Chronicle reports that the DeKalb City Manager is working with student leaders to find ways to get Huskies downtown. This is an attempt to foster better communication between the students and the city. Student Association Senate Speaker Christine Wayne says that many students don't know about the bars, the indoor skate park, or the restaurants in downtown DeKalb. The city is looking to increase its social media presence to advertise to the students.
A local activist group is encouraging citizens to let their voices be heard. NTC reporter Emma Kane has more with the story.
Action Steps for America hosts a meeting at the DeKalb Public Library. Communities across America are coming together to see what can be done locally to act against the Trump administration. These groups are reaching out to their local politicians for help. Adam Kingsinger, the representative in the 16th District, is the politician the DeKalb group is reaching out to. These DeKalb citizens are worried about the country and will do anything they can do to help.
It was really difficult for me to hear every day what was happening in our country, and sit at home. I started to feel sick and scared, and I decided that I needed to get active and do something to make a change.
Action Steps for America reaches out to any citizen that wants to see a change in government. NIU student Kelsey Williams is affected by the new government and wanted to get involved. She encourages anyone who wants to see a change in the new administration to join.
There are people who their whole lives have been Republican, have been conservative, have voted red, who are starting to be a little bit concerned about things, and I want them to be involved too.
Williams joined last week and is now in charge of all social media for the group. Each week, her and Moses plan meetings around DeKalb to continue with the movement. Other Illinois districts have not been successful getting their representatives to attend meetings. Representative Kingsinger has been invited to future meetings, and the group hopes he will attend in the near future. At the DeKalb Public Library for NTC News, I'm Emmett Kane.
For more information on Action Steps for America, you can follow them on Facebook and Twitter by searching DeKalb Action Steps for America.
For the past couple of weeks, Northern Star has written a series called Not From There, the Undocumented Series. It is a four-part series about the undocumented immigrants and the fear they have of deportation. Keith Hernandez, the reporter of this series, is here to talk about the topic. How are you doing, Keith?
Pretty well, thank you.
So, a couple questions. How did you find this series, and what pushed you to cover?
I started writing about the series because of the immigration executive orders passed by Donald Trump. I felt like the undocumented population would be the most vulnerable, and underrepresented.
Okay, and how did you find these undocumented immigrants? Did they come to you? Did you go out and seek them?
If I remember right, I reached out to Dream Action NIU because that was a group that was first started to advocate for and provide resources for undocumented students.
Okay, and then for those who aren't familiar with the DACA law, can you explain that and how it helps the students?
Well, I'm not an expert, but it essentially allows undocumented people who came here at a certain age as children to be able to stay in the country. And it's not a legal status, but it allows them to avoid deportation for up to 2 years. And it also provides a work permit as well.
Okay, and in one of these articles, you say that they go into the school, the elementary school, without knowing English. Can you explain some of the hardships of not knowing English in an English school?
Well, obviously, it'd be hard to learn on the same pace as other students, but not only that, you eventually will start forgetting your own language and how to communicate with your parents and whatnot. So there are some issues with that.
So with your own language, you mentioned that CLEAR was put in a subtractive program. And can you explain more on how that helps a student get through school?
Well, as it was explained to me, subtractive programs are not very good for education because it focuses on English rather than two languages at once. When you're not literate in two languages, you're not going to do as well as people who are. And you also kind of forget your culture after a while as well.
Okay, and then in the latest story, you talked about the possibility of a parent being deported without the kid and the kid staying here. So can you say how does that benefit or how does that hurt the kid?
I don't think there's any benefit in that at all because the kid in this situation, this is what's called like a mixed status family. And so the kid is technically a citizen and will probably be a ward of the state unless there is other relatives in the area that can take care of him. And it just breaks up the family and leads to a whole bunch of other issues.
And then lastly, how did you feel about covering this series?
I was pretty taken aback by how the struggle that these students go through and how much work they do on a daily basis. They have full-time jobs and they go to school full-time, and the only way they can pay for it is through private scholarships and the money that they make themselves. So,
all right, well, that's all. Thank you, Keith.
Many buildings around campus will be without steam today. An email was sent out saying a strainer is severely leaking in a steam tunnel under the bus turnaround by Watson Creek. Because of the leak, Gable, Graham, DuSable, Revis, Watson, and Zuloff Halls, as well as the child care building, will be without steam. The outage began around 11 a.m. this morning, but isn't expected to last more than a few hours. With today's climate, the only real effect will be the loss of hot water. Lindsay Park has a quick look at what to expect as far as temperatures go today.
It is a nice cloudy day here in DeKalb. The high temperature will reach around 50 degrees and will dip down to a low of 39 by tonight. It looks like we might be getting in thunderstorms around our area, and by the weekend, we might see our temperatures drop back down into the 30s. So to hear more about that, stay with us and back to you guys.
Coming up next on NTC News, how transgender students might be affected by the Trump administration's proposed guidelines. Also, a familiar face and voice takes on the mic on campus. We'll have that story.
Adopted, I've learned a lot about these humans.
I know, I mean, check out these two. It's Flirt City over here.
Yeah, I noticed that. It looks like my human is definitely into your human.
Oh, look, I think she's getting his number.
Nice.
Your human's got some sweet moves.
Takes after his dog. Oh, look, they're doing that thing where they put their arms around each other.
She kicked up a leg. It's like in the movies.
That's awesome. Looks like we're going to be hanging out a little bit more.
The Trump administration has removed federal protections for transgender students. During the Obama presidency, school districts that received federal funding were directed to let students use restrooms and other facilities corresponding with their gender identity. The Trump administration says issues like transgender bathrooms access are best dealt with at state level.
New cabinet members join the Trump administration. New rules are added this week.
Lark Lewis has more in today's Political Pit Stop.
Thank you. President Trump has named a new national security advisor. Lieutenant General Herbert Raymond McMaster has replaced Michael Flynn after his resignation last week.
Mr. President, thank you very much. I'd just like to say what a privilege it is to be able to continue serving our nation. I'm grateful to you for that opportunity, and I look forward to joining the national security team and doing everything I can to advance and protect the interests of the American people. Thank you very much, sir.
McMaster is known for his work in the Gulf War, Operation Iraqi Freedom, and his book, Dereliction of Duty, that critiqued the Vietnam War. He will remain in active duty while serving under Trump. The president's immigration ban is growing to include some new rules. The Department of Homeland Security released two memos outlining who will be a priority when it comes to deportation. Any person in the country illegally who has committed a crime will be high on the list. Under the Obama administration, those who had only committed serious felonies were deemed a priority.
So we've been working very closely with the Department of State, Department of Homeland Security, Department of Justice, and the team here at the White House to make sure that the next step achieves the president's goal of protecting the country and does so in a way that recognizes the concerns of the court had until we prevail at a later time.
Meanwhile, the memos did not make changes to the Obama administration's DREAM Act, which temporarily protected children of illegal immigrants from immediate deportation. President Trump spoke out on recent anti-Semitic attacks this week after facing criticism over his lack of attention to the threats. Over 150 headstones were overturned at a Jewish cemetery in St. Louis on Monday, and numerous bomb threats were reported at Jewish community centers nationwide.
The anti-Semitic threats targeting our Jewish community and community centers are horrible and are painful, and a very sad reminder of the work that still must be done to root out hate and prejudice and evil.
The Anti-Defamation League reports that the number of violent anti-Semitic attacks in the United States rose 3% in 2015. That's all I have for you today. See you next week on Political Pit Stop.
Thank you, Lark. The state of Illinois is recommending more than $77 million for NIU in the 2018 fiscal year. This comes after 2 years of not receiving full state funding because of the state budget crisis. The Northern Star reports that the current proposal is still in 15% less than the last time the school received full funding.
Neptune Hall will soon undergo some changes. The Board of Trustees approved a plan to renovate the dining and lounge areas and add some new furniture. New carpet and fresh paint are also in the works. The budget for this project is more than $4 million, and there are no plans to add central air conditioning because of the cost. Renovations are expected to be completed in time for fall semester.
NIU hosted an internship fair where companies gathered to tell students how they can get real work experience. I went to check it out.
Hundreds of students gathered in the Convocation Center to participate in the annual internship fair. Students were able to receive feedback from career services on their resumes and also do research on participating companies. Aldi, Art Band, Speedway, and other companies gave students the opportunity to present themselves and to even learn about possible internships.
Career Services Executive Director Brandon Lagana believes that internship fairs are the key to connect to the real world.
Well, Career Services developed the internship fair as a way for students to meet employers for the purposes of gaining internships. And the best way to have the application of what you're learning in class to connect with the real world is through an internship.
It also says that the internship fair is very important for students to be able to network with companies.
The days are very, very valuable to students because they're getting connected to employers and getting interviews.
I also included free headshots for students, and the annual job fair will take place the following day.
Career Services offers several more resources for students who are looking for internships.
If you aren't looking for an internship and instead are looking to get a good start on your career, NIU also has a full-time job fair. Many companies that gathered in Barsima Hall were looking for hard-working students who are able to graduate. NIU students got the opportunity to get information about possible careers. Anthony Shulo of AO Solutions has advice for students on how to best position themselves for job interviews.
Build your network and don't be afraid to reach out to people. I think that's a big thing for new grads is that can be very scary to reach out to new people and put your name out there. But go ahead and reach out to who you know. You know, use LinkedIn, use your professors, and do what you can to put yourself out there. Don't be afraid to.
NIU will be hosting another job fair in the fall of 2017.
DeKalb community gathered Wednesday evening for severe weather safety. The DeKalb Police and Fire Department gave the local community knowledge to remain confident in severe weather situations. They spoke about how to spot severe weather and stay safe from falling debris. DeKalb Police and Support Commander Jason Leverton said the goal is to prepare residents to be storm ready.
The city of DeKalb went through a certification process about 18 months ago to be certified as a storm ready community. And as part of that, we committed to hosting weather spotter class for the public. So our facility is open tonight to host a class to help train people that are interested in learning more about the weather.
The DeKalb area has experienced 16 tornadoes since 1958.
Well, it doesn't look like there are any tornadoes out there today. Lindsay is here with us now to catch us up on the recent weather.
Lindsay, tell us about this awesome weather we have been experiencing.
It has been a great week with this amazing weather. I know I have enjoyed it. I hope you guys have as well.
I've definitely enjoyed it.
Great, yeah. We've had some record-breaking temperatures. We've had 4 days in a row of record-breaking high temperatures. And then the fifth day, it didn't quite make it, but then on the sixth day, it did. So we've had amazing weather lately. But for today, we won't get to the record. We will have a high of 50 degrees with a low of 39, which is above normal for this time of the year still. Then taking a look at our local campus, it looks like we do have some overcast skies. Winds coming in from the northwest at around 10 to 15 miles an hour. So it's just a little breezy, but not too bad. Taking a look at the local or at our larger map, looks like we still have some overcast skies. We also have in towards our west possible rain and snow coming our way into Friday, which will give us those thunderstorms and those cloudy days that we are expecting. Then going into Saturday, it looks like we do have a cold front moving past us, giving those colder temperatures for the weekend. Taking it back to tonight, it looks like we do have a low of 39 degrees. Mostly cloudy skies. We will be getting some thunderstorms later on tonight. Going into tomorrow, we will have a high of 60 degrees. Mostly cloudy skies. Again, we will have scattered showers and thunderstorms. Also, we will have wind gusts up to 30 miles an hour, so it will be a little breezy again. For tomorrow night, we will have a low of 29 degrees. Mostly cloudy skies. Pretty chilly, but we will be expecting snow for the weekend. So taking a look at our 7-day forecast, it looks like Friday is going to be a high of 60 degrees. Thunderstorms are expected. Saturday will be a high of 33 degrees with chance of snow throughout the weekend. Then temperatures will start to increase throughout the next week. Tuesday will be a high of 56 degrees and thunderstorms. So it looks like our weather doesn't know what it wants to do. If it wants to be cold or warm, it's going to be a crazy week. So I'm excited for the ride. I hope you guys are. And that is it for the weather. I am Lindsay Park, and let's take it back to the desk.
If you've ever been to a Blackhawks game, you might have recognized the sounds coming from Barsima Hall yesterday.
Oh, say can you see?
Jim Cornelison belted out the national anthem in front of dozens of NIU students. Cornelison has been singing for the Hawks since the 2008 and 2009 season. Cornelison says he has a soft spot for NIU.
I love NIU. I have a good friend who teaches in the business school here at Barsima Hall, Eric Wozowicz. So I was out here a couple years ago and did the anthem, and then I've been out for a football game as well. Go Huskies!
Cornelison has three championship reigns with the Blackhawks. Ahead on NTC News, our own Emily Becerra shares her love for gymnastics with us. She's this week's leader of the pack. Plus, the Blackhawks take on the Western Conference leaders, and it was wild. We'll have highlights in sports.
Wow, these are really good.
You act surprised. Practice makes perfect.
You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. There are thousands of teens in foster care who don't need perfection.
In this week's Leader of the Pack, we feature NIU gymnast Emily Becerra. She talks about her mid-season comeback to the mats.
I'm Emily Becerra, and this is Leader of the Pack.
NIU sophomore Emily Becerra was given a full-ride scholarship to make her childhood dream a reality. Becerra worked vigorously to get to the collegiate level as a gymnast. Driven by her determination to succeed, she would use her positive attitude to overcome obstacles in her way.
When I was really young, I was super clumsy, so my mom thought the best idea to fix that would be to put me into gymnastics. I just fell in love with the sport and everything it offered me.
Before her first ever collegiate competition, Emily suffered a torn ACL injury that put her aspirations to a sudden halt. Although, instead of giving up on her gymnastics career, Emily used her injury as a motivation to come back stronger than ever.
I was starting to get back and get my skills and everything. It was just even more motivation to come back for this season because, you know, it's just something I've been wanting to do for forever.
With inspiration from her family, teammates, and coaches, Emily was well on her path to recovery. And after a year of rehabilitation, Emily recovered from her injury and was cleared to get back on the mat.
I just went out there and I don't really remember the routine all that much because I was so nervous, but when I stuck the dismount, it really just put an exclamation point on everything I've been working for.
Emily has now completed two meets thus far, as she is currently limited to the uneven parallel bars event. She is currently training to perform in all four gymnastic events, possibly later this season.
The biggest thing you can do for someone is just to cheer them on and make them, you know, motivated, let them know that you're there for them, you know, you want them to succeed.
Emily's determination to maintain a positive attitude through challenging times makes her this week's leader of the pack. For NTC News, I am Eddie Garcia.
Becerra says she is on pace for a full recovery and awaits her time to step foot on the gymnastic mats and compete in all events.
Now here's Mike Mitchell with a look at sport.
Welcome to NTC Sports. Let's get started with the Bulls. The day is here at the NBA trade deadline. Questions remain for if the Bulls will choose to trade big names such as Jimmy Butler or Rajon Rondo, or if they'll decide to keep them all. Breaking news into our center. We have learned that Doug McDermott and Taj Gibson both have been traded to the Thunder. Stick with us for the latest. The Bulls' next game is tomorrow night when they take on the last place Phoenix Suns. We head out to Arizona, where Bulls Chicago teams kick off their spring training schedules this weekend. Saturday in Mesa, the Cubs will open up their spring training campaign against the Athletics. Mike Montgomery will be on the hill for the Cubs. Sunday's game will definitely be one to watch as they take on the Cleveland Indians. The Indians will look to avenge their World Series loss against the Northsiders. In Glendale, the White Sox will open their rebuilding campaign again this weekend against both the Dodgers and the Rockies. Sox will be looking for their top prospects to impress their new manager, Rick Renteria. Look out for players such as Johan Moncada. Tuesday night, the Blackhawks faced off against the league's best team, the Minnesota Wild. After a rather slow first period, the Blackhawks came out firing in the second. Captain Jonathan Toews led off with a goal, his 14th of the season. But the Wild answered back less than 4 minutes later. On the power play, Michael Granlund ties the game. Just 41 seconds later, though, the Hawks regain momentum. Jonathan Toews passes the puck over to Richard Panik, who gives the Hawks a 2-1 lead. Early in the third, Nick Schmaltz off the faceoff. He's going to snipe a goal, give the Hawks another goal, and give them a 3-1 advantage. Later in the third period, Zach Parise will put one through the net and cut the deficit down to one. However, less than 2 minutes later, Jonathan Toews scores his second goal of the game to restore the Hawks' two-goal lead. The Wild gave the Hawks a last-minute scare as Michael Granlund scores his second goal of the game, bringing the gap back to one. After the Wild pull their goalie, Jonathan Toews puts the game away with an empty net goal, giving him his first hat trick of the season. Hawks beat the Wild 5-3. The Hawks will continue their hot streak. Finally, in college hoops, watch this. As time was running down, Syracuse's John Gillen, he's going to get the ball and he's going to do something crazy. He's going to dribble down and he's going to throw up a prayer. And it's going to go off the backboard and in. They shock the country and they defeat number 10 Duke. With shots like that, all I can say is it March Madness yet? With the warm weather yet? I'm thinking spring. I'm Mike Mitchell. Have a great weekend. And as always, go Huskies.
NIU's Music Hall was filled with Broadway music and leafy greens on Sunday. All for a good cause. Reporter Emily Becerra has more.
Oak County Community Gardens held their third annual Make Our Garden Grow benefit concert in NIU's Boutel Memorial Concert Hall. The community gardens were hoping to raise about $4,000 to add to their Walnut Grove Vocational Farm program for youth with special needs. The community garden's main goal is to try to end hunger and food insecurity in the DeKalb area. The president of the DeKalb County Community Gardens, Dan Kenny, explains how he'd hoped this event would help out their program.
It'll help with DeKalb County Community Gardens to help us with the programs that we run to grow food for people in need in DeKalb County and increase access to fresh vegetables. Also, it goes to help our Walnut Grove Vocational Farm, where we work with individuals with special needs, teaching them horticulture and agricultural skills so that they can get more fully engaged in the community.
So many people showed up for the concert that there was only standing room available for those that arrived late. Those who came to the concert were encouraged to donate toward the cause by participating in the silent auction or just leaving donations at the door. The DeKalb Community Gardens has over 45 gardens all over the county that grow fresh produce for the local shelters, daycare centers, and even NIU's Husky Food Pantry. Kenny says that they are always in need of volunteers.
We have a garden on campus called the Communiversity Garden, which is located behind Anderson Hall. And the fresh vegetables from that garden go to the Husky Food Pantry. As soon as growing season begins, we'll be growing fresh vegetables in the Communiversity Garden. So we can use volunteers there. Students who are majoring in special education, we'd love to have their help up at the Walnut Grove Vocational Farm for individuals with special needs.
The fundraiser fell just short of the $4,000 goal, but it did spread awareness about the gardens and their purpose to the DeKalb community and NIU students. For NTC News, I'm Emily Becerra.
If you would like to get involved with DeKalb County Community Gardens, go online to dekalbgardens.org.
NTC News Tonight is produced and directed by students here at Northern Illinois University. For more on NTC News, look us up and like us on Facebook. You can also check out our website. In collaboration with WNIJ, we're going to leave you now with the band Hungry Mountain singing Weird Pills. We'll air Thursday night at 7 on 89.5 FM and WNIJ.org.
I took some weird pills, man. I took some weird pills, man. I took some weird pills, man. I took some weird pills. Double black diamonds in the sand. I wanna be like Paul McCartney and hold your hand. Drive you through the streets of Bo Kansas City. Show them ugly is the new pretty. We could maybe steal an electric streetcar, but baby, we would not be able to make it that far. Those things are connected to...